Two families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
How y'all doing? How you folks? How y'all doing? How's everybody? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? How's everybody? I appreciate y'all. Thank y'all. Thank y'all very much. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Well, welcome to Family Feud South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Well, we're gonna have buckets of fun tonight. I'm telling you, folks, listen, I'm excited to be here. All right, everybody, so let me tell you what we've done. Our researchers have been on the streets of Mzansi. Yeah. And they've been asking you some answers to some very simple questions. That answers to those questions are locked into our game board up here. All you got to do as a family member is try to guess those answers. And if you can guess the most of those answers, you get to walk away with a lot of serious money in here. Yeah. All right, if you're ready for the show to get started, everybody say yeah.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, from Stellenbosch in Cape Town, it's the Vermeulen family.
Is that it?
Vermeulen.
Vermeulen? Vermeulen.
Playing against from Albertine, right here in Joburg, it's the CHIRWA family. Everybody's here trying to win themselves a lot of cash so somebody could get a chance to play for the big jackpot, 75,000 rand. Let's get it on, man. Give me Marsha. Give me Miriam. Ladies, how are you?
Doing very well, as you?
And I'm doing absolutely wonderful.
Awesome. Thank you.
Welcome to the show. One hand on the desk, the other one behind your back. Thank you. If you think you know the answer, just hit the buzzer. We surveyed 100 people. We got top 4 answers, top 7 answers on the board. Name something you need for your dizemba vacation.
A bikini.
A bikini. I guess you better do that, girl. I'm putting on a bikini. I don't care when it is.
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses. Dane.
I would say alcohol, Steve.
Alcohol. Alcohol. Pass the plate.
Good play. Good play.
They're going to play. It's, Marcia?
Yeah, Marsha.
Marsha?
Yes.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a medical doctor.
Oh, excuse me. What type of doctor?
So, I work in the field of research on HIV and TB.
Oh, that's very important. Okay. Well, you're the team captain. Introduce us to your team.
So, this is my husband, Dane. That is my cousin, Crystal, my niece, Lauren Lee, and my baby brother, Christopher.
Okay, good. Well, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Dane?
Hi, Steve.
I'm glad. It took me a minute, because over there I was looking at it, and I think I'm dyslexic, so I thought it was Diane, and I was struggling. I said, I'm pretty sure this boy's name ain't Diane. What do you do for a living?
I'm a laboratory assistant at a university.
A laboratory assistant. Laboratory. Laboratory assistant. Where I'm from, laboratory assistant. Hi, Crystal.
Hi, Steve.
What do you do?
I'm a student at a university.
Oh, okay. What are you studying?
Humanities.
So when you get a degree in humanities, what kind of job do you qualify for?
Well, it's a social studies degree, so I want to be a writer.
A writer?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Woo.
Yeah.
See, I went to a university. And I flunked out. I flunked out of college. They put me out. They expelled me because my grades were so poor. And I flunked out of school. But I made it!
Yeah!
Yeah. Yeah, I started listening to a lot of Guam music and got me some Guam music. Gom, yeah, Gom, that's what it was. Got me some Gom music, and then I started, after I got some Gom music, got me some Amapato piano. I got some of that, and then after that, I got hold of me some Kuwait music. Quiet music. Yeah, I got all of that right there. I haven't learned a damn thing, have I?
Apparently not, Steve.
Huh?
I said apparently not, Steve.
Name something you need for your December vacation.
I would say money, Steve.
You need money. Hello, Lauren Lay.
Hello, Steve.
What do you do?
I'm a teacher.
Really?
Yeah.
With the hair and everything?
Everything.
Yeah, you better go on in there. Hello, students.
Yeah.
I decided to wear my December hat. So, are you married?
I'm engaged.
What? So let me ask you something. Your fiancé, is he here?
No.
No. So let me ask you a question. When he met you, was your hair this color?
No.
Are you crying?
Because I'm laughing.
Oh, so I ain't never been this damn funny before.
I'm not crying, I promise you that.
I've been funny, but I ain't been this damn funny. She laughing, just tears coming down. I'm sitting here going, I was gonna stop talking about your hair. I thought I said something. I was really scared. I went, oh, Jesus, she's crying. So when you told your boyfriend that you were going to color your hair, how did he like it?
No, he's always in for anything. Like hair color, I mean.
Let me ask you a question.
Christopher.
What do you do for a living?
I'm an agri business consultant.
Okay, I can't understand you either. Let me go back down here. Okay, I want you to come all the way down here. Come
oh
down
my goodness.
Here. Yeah, just come right here. Come stand right here. Right here. You're going to help me.
Understand.
You're going to translate. No, because she's a doctor, so she has. So you had to help me.
Okay.
I asked her, did her fiance like her hair? Yeah. What did she say?
Yes. She said yes, because he is into that. It doesn't matter.
Oh,
he doesn't care.
That's what you said.
I really don't understand.
No, I didn't know. No, I did not know what she said. She said yes, because he is a yes. So I need some help. I'm gonna go get an inter-family translator. Because I could understand her. Now, thank you. Now, okay. Now, look, I got to get her answer first.
Oh.
I'm going to get you, and then you stay right there because I already know we're going to have problems. Because when I ask him what he did, I ain't know what he said.
Oh.
So you stay right here. Name something you need for your December vacation.
I would say a family.
A family?
Yes!
All right, only one strike. Christopher? What do you do?
I'm an agri-business consultant. Agriculture.
Oh, agriculture,
yeah.
Business,
we just shorten it, agri-business consultant.
Oh, agri-business, you shorten it.
Yeah.
See, I didn't know what that was. When you said agri-business consultant, I did not know. Okay, so I'm not gonna have no trouble with you?
No.
So you can go back? Thank you. Okay. Name something you need for your December vacation.
I would say your visa or your passport.
You need your visa or your passport? Marcia, we got two strikes now. We need to be careful, okay? The Chira family can steal. Name something you need for your December vacation.
Food, Steve.
You need food. All right, here we go, guys. Name something you need for your December vacation.
Entertainment, Steve.
Entertainment.
Good answer, good answer, good answer.
Number seven.
Six.
Five.
Airtime.
Number four.
Cooler boss.
Three.
New
boss. Well, we got a good one, folks. Familian family got 52. CHIRWA family not on the board. Don't go away. We'll be right back. We're playing Family Feud, everybody. I like these families. It's nice. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Female and family got 52. CHIRWA family not on the board. Give me Dane. Give me Kasuna. Did I say your name?
Yes, you did.
Kasuna.
Kasuna, yeah.
You better high five me, girl. What's up, Dane?
Hey, Steve.
All right, let's go. Top seven answers on the board. Here we go. Name something people do to look younger.
Facelift.
A facelift.
Anti-aging creams?
Anti-aging cream.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Crystal?
Yes.
Name something people do to look younger.
I'm gonna say makeup, Steve.
Makeup!
Woo! Good answer. Nice, good answer. Nice, nice. Yes!
I have some on right now.
I can see, Steve.
Yes. You know what, man? I hate makeup.
Me too.
I've been putting it on for so many years on television. As soon as I get off work, as soon as I go in the back, makeup pads, I get it off. This is gonna be a good one for you. Lauren Lay, name something people do to look younger.
I would say the way they dress.
The way they dress. Christopher, name something people do to look younger.
Steve, I would say people drink that detoxing juices to look younger.
Good answer! Yay!
Woo! Good answer! Detoxing juices.
Good answer!
A miracle juice, Steve.
Huh? Oh, juice.
A miracle juice. They make most that concoctions. No.
America has a juice?
No, a miracle juice.
Like a miracle juice.
Yeah.
Detoxing miracle juice. One strike. Marcia, name something people do to look younger.
They keep fit.
Good answer.
Woo. Good answer.
Say it again for me.
They keep fit. They exercise. So to keep
themselves
fit. Oh,
they keep fit?
Yes.
Oh. They keep fit. Dane, name something people do to look younger.
I would say, Steve, they change their hair.
They change their hair. Crystal, only one strike. You can clear the board. Name something people do to look younger.
I would say they get themselves a younger partner, Steve.
You get yourself, let me see if I can remember this, a sleigh queen. Yeah. And then you, the sleigh queen, try to find a blesser. I've been learning, man. I've been learning. This game has taught me a lot. Get someone younger. Lauren Lay, two strikes. We have to be careful. Hey, Chira family, you can steal. Get ready.
Okay.
He said, okay. You're not supposed to say nothing back. You're just supposed to go like that. Lauren Lay, name something people do to look younger.
They drink pills.
They drink pills! Name something people do to look younger.
Eating healthy,
yep.
Steve.
Eating healthy. That's a smart answer. I like that. Eating healthy. Nate, that was a good answer. That was a really good answer. No, that was a good answer. Hey, remember this about Family Feud. This isn't a game of right or wrong. Number six. That's round two, everybody. Vermeulen family 141. CHIRWA family not on the board. Don't go anyway. After the break, families are gonna be playing for double the points. You'll be fine. It's only round two. You're playing well, folks. We'll be right back, y'all. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game from Ellen family, got 141. CHIRWA family not on the board. Give me Crystal, give me him. Come on.
You could, sir.
Yeah, Steve.
Okay, man.
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna give it a shot.
First of all, good luck.
You already know I'm not gonna get
this. It's all right. It was chosen for a purpose, Steve, so it's
okay. It was chosen for a purpose.
It was chosen for a purpose.
So when you meet people like me, they just look dumb.
Don't worry. My mom couldn't say it anyway, so there's a different one, but I had to go with this one.
Mixolacy.
Out of 10, I would give you a 7.
Okay. What is it? What is it?
Mixolacy.
Mixolacy.
There you go!
Mixolacy. I'm learning, man.
Yeah, man.
Here we go. Top 7 answers on the board, guys. Name something a singer would say to a crowd at a concert.
What song do you want to hear next?
What song y'all want to hear next?
Yes.
Are you there?
Are you there?
Are you there?
Are you there?
Yeah.
I am here. Yeah. The answer is up there. Is it there?
Yeah.
What do you do? What do you do?
We're gonna play, man. Let's go. Let's go, man. Miss Miriam, how y'all doing?
Doing very well, Steve.
Girl, I finally got over here.
Yeah, yeah.
I was a little worried about that. Yeah. I said, you dressed up so nice, be so nice, be over here, meet everybody. And then you finally sent over there, you sent
Yes, I knew you would struggle. Then I thought, yeah, that would be good for Steve.
What relation are you to him?
He's my brother-in-law.
He's your brother.
He's married to my husband's sister.
And that's me.
What do you do, Miss Miriam?
Before I go to that, Steve, you know what happened, Steve? I saw the newspaper. When I read the newspaper, I saw Steve is coming into South Africa. I'm telling you, Steve, I started panicking. My heart was beating.
Yes.
I said, whoever I saw on the road, Steve, I you know what I said? Do you know who is Steve Harvey?
What? What? What?
When they said yes, I said, he's coming to South Africa.
He's coming! I tell you, he is coming.
He's coming to South Africa.
He is coming. He is here.
He is here. I'm telling you, Steve, that's what happened. That's what I wanted to tell you. So I'm happy. Yes, I'm here today. It's happening.
Yes, happening.
Yes.
Because. Steve Harvey is here. Oh, yes.
Steve is here.
Harvey is here. Oh, yes.
Is here.
Steve Harvey is here.
Oh, yeah,
he's here.
Oh, Steve
Harvey is here. Oh, yeah,
he's here.
Steve Harvey is here. Oh, yeah, he's here. Harvey is here. Oh, yes,
Harvey is here.
Oh, yes, he's here. Harvey is here. Oh, yeah. You're the star of the show. Boy. All right, now introduce everybody.
Right.
Pull yourself together.
Right. This is Kasuna, my daughter. That is Mkolisi, my brother-in-law. That is Eleni, my husband's sister. And that is Julius.
Oh, yes. Uncle Julius.
My husband. Hello, sweetie pie.
Hello, darling. Hello.
She looked down there, she said, and that down there, that's, hello, sweetie pie. Hi, Ellen.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, what do you do?
I'm a fixed asset controller.
Fixed asset controller?
Yes.
Okay. I've learned not to ask y'all nothing else. I can say fixed asset controller. I understood it perfectly. Let's just move on. Name something a singer would say to a crowd at a concert.
Are you having fun?
Are you having fun? Are you having fun? Uncle Julius, name something a singer would say to a crowd at a concert.
If they're fit.
To dance.
Ask them if they're fit.
If they're fit to dance, because there will be a vibe in the studio.
Yes, yes.
Yes. So how fit they are. Are you ready to...
Yes. Are you fit? Are you ready to dance? Are you ready to dance? Are you ready to dance?
To shake your body.
Are you ready to
shake your body?
Are you ready for... Are you ready to shake your body? They've changed that now. It's booty. Are you ready to shake your booty, your body? Only one strike. Name something a singer would say to a crowd at a concert. You was probably at the concert with him.
Are you enjoying yourself there?
Are you enjoying yourself there? Well, get up and shake your body.
You enjoying yourself? All right, Christina, here we go. Listen to me. We got two strikes. We got to be careful. The other family can steal. Name something a singer would say to a crowd at a concert.
I'd say, wave your hands in the air.
Wave your hands in the air. Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't worry about it.
Okay, names. Steve, let me do you one favor.
Okay, cool. Listen.
Olisi is rather tough.
Olisi.
There we go. There we go.
Okay. Yeah,
not so tough for me.
No, not tough anymore.
Not
no
so
chance,
no more.
My friend.
Because really? You know why?
Why?
Because the African in me is slowly emerging. Now you name something a singer would say at a crowd, say to a crowd at a concert.
Encore. Oh, we say it encore.
Yeah, that's what the crowd.
Encore.
Listen to me. Name something a singer.
Yes.
Would say to a crowd.
Yes.
At a concert.
Yes.
Okay. Well. Yeah. Encore. Name something a singer would say to a crowd at a concert.
We decided on welcome, everyone.
Yeah. Welcome, everyone. Number 7.
Say.
3. Two. Number 1.
Sing-a-long.
Well, that's round 3, everybody. We got a game now. VERMEULEN family got 141. CHIRWA family got 54. Don't go away, folks, because after the break, we're going to be playing double the points. We got a game now. Let's get it on. We're playing Feud. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Now, we got a game, folks. VERMEULEN family got 141. CHIRWA family got 54. Give me Lauren Lee. Give me Ellen. Ladies, welcome to the show. Point values are double. We've got the top 6 answers on the board. Name something you associate with a funeral.
Crying.
Crying. Crying.
Coffin. Coffin.
The coffin.
Yes.
The coffin. They're gonna play?
They're playing.
They're gonna play. My man, Uncle Julius. Name something you associate with the funeral.
Undertakers.
Undertakers.
Thank you for this.
Okay, Mary. Name something you associate with the funeral.
Flowers.
Flowers. Kasuna. Name something you associate with the funeral.
A dead body.
A dead body. You must have a dead body to have a funeral. This is not working without the body. Where is the body? The dead body. Is this for real? My man.
Yeah.
Name something you associate with a funeral.
A grave.
The grave.
Go. The grave. Let's go.
I'm scared to ask the question. I want to apologize. I don't know what. You gave really good answers. Name something you associate with the funeral.
Wearing black.
Wearing black. Number four. You don't have a funeral at the you don't have it at the church. At the gravesite, the tent. Number three. What's number one?
Food.
Food. Number one. What are y'all doing? You done set up a tent and you're eating? You don't even have a body. In this last round, Vermeulen's got 141 and the Chihuahua's got 120. Whoever gets the most points at the end of this round goes on to play the fast money round for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. But remember, jackpot round or not, you are trying to get the most points you can because you walk away with serious money that way. Let's get it on. Give me Christopher. Give me Uncle Junior. In this round, the points are triple. We've surveyed 100 people. We got top five answers on the board. Name an excuse for lateness that bosses are tired of hearing.
They overslept.
You overslept. Julius.
Traffic.
Traffic. That's a good moment right there. Ms. Miriam, name an excuse for lateness that bosses are tired of hearing.
My child is sick.
Sick?
Yes.
Good answer, ma'am. Good answer.
Sick! Basuna.
Yep.
Name an excuse for lateness that bosses are tired of hearing.
I had to go to the doctor.
I had to go to the doctor.
Good answer.
There's one answer left on that board. If you get this answer right here, you have no strikes. Your family wins the game and will be playing for 75,000 rand.
What's up?
If you miss it, you have no strikes. Name an excuse for lateness that bosses are tired of hearing.
Load shedding.
I like that. Yeah, that's real. That's real. I'm tired of this load shit and driving somewhere, ain't no damn traffic lights. I'll be going, what is what? Load shedding. Only one strike, Ellen. You will be next, Uncle Julius, if she misses. Name an excuse for lateness that bosses are tired of hearing.
Service delivery strike.
Service delivery strike.
Yes.
One answer left, two strikes. Uncle Julius, if it's there, your family wins the game, your family plays for 75,000 Rand. If it's not there, the Vermeulen family can steal and they win the game. Uncle Julius, name an excuse for lateness that bosses are tired of hearing.
Breakdown of the car.
The car broke down. This is for the win, the breakdown of the car. Folks, let me tell you something, family. You all played this game really, really well. You should be very proud of yourself. You all did absolutely wonderful. You just ran up into Uncle Julius, that's all. Hey, folks, you played well, and because you got 141 points, you're taking home 7,050 Rand, and you walk out of here with a year's supply of KFC worth 10,000 Rand. Enjoy your family. Have a feast for a whole year. You folks are really nice, man. You really, really were. Hey, folks, who's playing Fast Money? I need two of you. Come on, let's go. We'll be right back. We're gonna play Fast Money. Both of them. Right after this. Welcome back to the feud, everybody. The CHIRWA family won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, here's how Fast Money works. Kasuna, he can't see or hear your answers, okay?
Okay?
I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass.
Okay.
Try to give me the most popular answers. If you can't think of something, just say pass. If we have enough time, we'll get back to it later. If you and M. Lucy together get 200 points, tell everybody what you're gonna win.
75,000 Rand.
Yeah. You ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name a popular biscuit in a box of assorted Christmas biscuits.
Choc chip.
Name something you need for a kid's princess party.
A crown.
A word to compliment a woman.
Beautiful.
Something you should not drop.
The soap.
Something you might find in an ice cream container.
Ice cream.
All right, let's turn around and see what we got. All right, here we go, darling. Name a popular biscuit in a box of assorted Christmas biscuits. You said chocolate chip. Survey said? something you need for a kid's princess party. You said crown. Survey said? A word to compliment a woman. You said beautiful. Survey said? Wow. Wow. Something you should not drop. You shocked everybody. You said you can't drop the soap. Survey said? Name something you might find in an ice cream container. You said some ice cream. Rather obvious. Survey said? All right, good job. All right, my man, let's go. Clear the board. All right, man. Your niece, she did pretty good. She got 128 points. But I gotta tell you, man, 72 points is tough to get in the second position. But you can do it. All right, I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you'll give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we're gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of Kasuna's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. The clock will start after I read the first question. Come on, man, let's win this money. Name a popular biscuit in a box of assorted Christmas biscuits.
Oreos.
Something you need for a kid's princess party.
Balloons.
A word to compliment a woman.
You're beautiful.
I'll try again.
Wow.
Something you should not drop.
A phone.
Something you might find in an ice cream container.
Ice cream cone.
Ice cream cones. Let's go. Let's see how we did, buddy. All right, here we go, brother. Let's go. We need 72 points.
Yep.
Name a popular biscuit in a box of assorted Christmas biscuits. You said Oreos. Survey said? Something you need for a kid's princess party. You said balloons. Survey said? All right, let me give you the number one answers. The most popular biscuit was chocolate. And the number one thing for a kid's princess party is crown. You needed a crown. 60 points away, let's go. A word to compliment a woman, you said, wow. Survey said? Beautiful. Beautiful was number one. We need a couple of big ones, buddy, let's go. Something you should not drop. Better not drop that phone, buddy. Survey said? Boom. Phone was the number one answer. 26 points away from 75,000 rand. Something you might find in an ice cream container. You said ice cream cones. Survey said? Leftovers. Leftovers. Well, I'm sorry, but hey, folks, we're gonna triple your points. So they're walking out of here with 45,300 rand. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.